He used to,
when he comes to a gathering of this, when brother said something, if the words are very blasphemous words and good words, he doesn't
want
to add on anything. He said, what he came here for, the reason for his presence. He usually comes from Gambia to visit his younger brother, Ahmed Kebe, who's in New Jersey, and the rest of the brothers. He works at the United Nations.
And
a lot of the other fellow Murids in the Sariqa who are in this country. That's the reason why he came down to Michigan to visit some of the movies. Long ago he went to Indiana to visit Brother Musa.
David Kentucky.
And also he had visited
Memphis.
And also as Memphis.
Maryland
as well.
All
of this is just to visit with the Murids. When he came here, this young lady, Mampenda, he did mention me to him.
Islam.
With the efforts we all try to get for this deen. The effort that boss all of you have doing for the sake of this deen. I wanted him to come and extend his visit. He said, knowing each other is the root cause of mercy. If you pass by and two people fighting, and you don't even know one of them, you would just say, these people are just fighting, and then you will walk your way. But if you know one of those who are fighting, you will not go, you will stay wait. Then if he finds out that one of us is working in this
deen,
and we all share the same religion, Allah help even bless us further to share the same tariqa Tijani
as well.
Then if he comes into this country,
and
there is a masjid right next to his house, and they would always do this zikr Juma or every day. If he was told that somebody is doing it will encourage him to come and be present, knowing that these are his Muslim brothers and sisters. These are his Muslim fellow Tijanis. That's the reason why he
came,
for the sake of Allah, just to visit and to know each other. And he was even blessed further to meet
him.
Because the reason why he calls him Chise
Chise,
they have this kind of a relationship between
Chise
and
Chise.
He will always joke towards those who are Chise. In Maulids.
Did it?
In Gamo. Okay, this cousinhood that happens between us.
Well, okay. Mom.
And then having this grandparents, and then cousins and grandparents. These are the relationships that make relationship easier. Without these relationships, we would have a lot of difficulties.
Mom,
grandparents,
lum am makama,
no matter how high or how elevated they are in position, they can never do anything towards their grandchildren. They don't want nothing to harm their grandkids. If you're angry, no matter how far you're angry, and you come into a cousin or somebody whom you joke with, when they come in, you will laugh. If you go to your uncle's house, and your cousins, the sons of your uncle, are there, and they are so angry, and nobody can talk to them. If you arrive as a cousin, you can say whatever you want to him, and make him laugh, and uncle will not stop it. That's why he's thanking Sheikh Ibrahim. He said, if we were just to listen to what he said, that would
suffice
us. He said, there was a little thing that the Muslims are lacking. The ayah Qur'an that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the believers are together, and they are strong against the non-believers, and they are merciful towards one another. We lack that. Now you find that the Muslims are fighting against one another. They have left their path that was set for them.
Huh?
This is it. This is the biggest cause of our problems. If you continue with this ayah,
mune dang leen gi traawum do kan su jene yaptu ko na fatlal mel ray wure dam simaawum fi wujuy him min asiru sujud salika masalum fi tawral masalum fi injil waye bu boba mune da nga gis ño xamne ruko bañuy ruko ak sujud bañuy sujud day saxas sen xoli bam set ba fuñ tollu jiko bi du taru jëm ji de taru jiko bi jiko bu rafet bi nga am de ko jeflante nit ñi mom lañ doon sentu ci mom waye du soccu ba son ci njampé wu diwu ñu ne diwa nge leer kurus gi mu reey du lolu xol bi moy rafet bu doto rus nga def ken lu bon rus nga wax lu bon rus nga ko def do bañ ken do soxate ken
il say wana allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sayyid al-quran tarahu rukan sujada you see the If you see them, Allah said in the Quran, "Tarahum ruk'an sujada." You see them prostrating and then bowing down, and then you see the signs of their belief is manifested on their faces. He said, "That is not the shower or the cream that you put on your face to lighten you up and brighten your skin. It is the sujuds and the ruku'a that purifies your heart, purifies your soul, that comes out to shine in your face, that when people see you, they see the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you are merciful amongst one another. Sallallahu alayhi wa said, if you are a guest in a place, and you have some inquiries, look amongst the people who have the shiniest face. The brightest face, who has it, if you expose to him your problem, he will. Because they ask him why, they say whatever is in the heart manifests on the face. Now it's very, very difficult.
He said, he's thanking Sheikh
Ibrahim. Where we should start, we have left it.
For Nachi, I'm not for your tail, being a Hanumum, Nupuyap Nankuni, Dalibi, Janga, my lottery.
Yeah, one of the small book, the one we're studying, which is the
Hamsulal.
It's a small book, but it's a very important book.
Lam Yoh, one way, Tashihul Iman.
The beginning of it is a Tashihul Iman to purify or to have it, the best Iman.
Wow, legal. Bimu waxe tasul iman.
He said to correct your iman.
Mu door la andi julle ko jappak nangam.
After he said the tasihul iman, which is to correct your iman, he followed it with the salat and then the tahara and the rest of it.
Way jital na ci digal bi suma marifatuma. Mu door la wak akami.
Before he carries on, he says suma marifatuma, knowing what then brings in the ahkam, the rules of what you should know, which is the salat and tahara. And then the salat and tahara and siyam, the right. Fasting and all of those stuff.
The fakir and salat and tahara.
Does not make your iman correct. If that was the case, those who are killers, those who are making salat and making wudu, they will not kill anybody. But those are the biggest killers nowadays. He said today he did his tashihul iman, the purification of his iman. He said he heard that Imam Daw is a good person. He made an effort to come and visit him.
Well,
tomorrow if they tell him Imam Daw is a tall person, they tell him if he's a white man, he'll refuse.
Why gisna ne kuyatula? Because
he came and seen him. He knows he's a short guy.
Must now wax say ndaw mané. Jami yalla bu ko mel tan maté ci bir mbubam. Wala sank len dug ci bir mbub mi. Bu ko yele be muta naka la def? Musumi mbub mi. Fexé bam de lutax bakkan jaar digënté ru ak yalla té dakkuñ bakkan ru delu ci yalla.
A human being, if you are bit by a mosquito or by a bug inside your clothes, you would take your clothes, you would try to shake it off. If it doesn't come off, you would take your clothes off. And if you would take your clothes off to make sure you get rid of it. Why would you let your nafs be between you and your Lord, and you do not remove your nafs from between you and Allah to make your soul progress?
Mm-hmm.
This is the problem.
Why when Allah fafiru ila Allah,
when Allah told us run towards Allah,
legi bima bayiko nakala fofu tuddu
new jere
dedet fima joge ni ci mampena
oh waterfall
when he was leaving waterfall
mang fa baye yalla
he left Allah there
may ko romba ci yoon
he passed Allah on his way
muhandak man
and Allah was with him
ma ñew fekk ko fi
he came and found him here
te suma joge wëccat ko fi
and if he gets up he will
dina ko romba ci yoon
and he will pass him back
dina ko fekkat fama
dem he will meet him where
kon fan lay daw dem ci mom
where can he run to Allah
moy li ki don haye ko ci ro ila moy dawlen lepp lu neexul yalla bayileen ko mo leena yakal ndax yalla amu ci xoy yalla muno ko defal fek nga muy yalla so jamul yalla muy yalla soko jamo yi muy yalla doko yokal doko wagne kon bi nga daw de dem ci mom dedet da nga daw lepp lum la tere te bi nga dawe waxut nga taxaw de taxaw bam fa wa ana ila rabbikal munta hagagula woro taxawalu
he said when you, he said fafirru ila Allah run towards Allah where can you run to him if everywhere you go he is there where can you run to him so fafirru ila Allah run towards Allah by running away from everything that is prohibited from you to do so when you run away from what is prohibited to you you would get to Allah but he said but are you going to have a destination there is no destination but ila the destination is to Allah subhanahu wa
ta'ala shukrafe gorgindaw jerejeuf ñu ngi leena sant
he's grateful and thanking everybody
ñu ngi gërem ñëpp
he's thanking everybody that's present
ñu ngi sant yalla yit
thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
ci réew mo xamne
in this country
ñu mel ni ñu fa te yalla rekay seen soxla
that we have these kinds of faces that are only seeking but Allah
ñun fiñu bayiko soorina de
where he came from is very far from here
ñeneen ni fiñu bayiko soorina
other some of you also came from far
te ken ul ci wut fi ci kër gi xaaliss yalla rek
and no one came here looking for money because I ain't giving you nothing but you came here looking for Allah
ko defé nak benen bi ma ci tek
the other thing that he will say
mo leem ñi fi nek
everyone who's present
li len andi
what brought you here
lu interlé sen njobot
what to have something that you can help your family or support
lu interlé sen kalifa
and you would something you would support those of who are your parents
nu def ba mana dund ci lew san sam sen ngor
something that would help you to live a healthy and a protective life or life that is blessed and sanctity life
lolu mo len fi andi
and that's the reason why we all came to this country
fi ngeen ko oute metti lol
and the way we have to find it is very difficult because we would have to work hard
bu dur waxti ngeen dajje mok amul ko rombe ci benn mi xamul la xamoko
if it is not the moments that we get and sit together there is no fun
te ñi fi nek yeen ñoo bokk ko ñoo daqé te koku duñ koy jot
all of us are running towards one thing and we'll never catch it
ki ñuy daq nonu kuko jot yalla le ko teel way xaliss du lo meena jot
all we are running after one thing which is money and no one can catch it except whom Allah blesses to stop that money and give it to
you tuba mi defar nañu welo soti wul
they made bikes and it doesn't work
ñu defar auto soti wul
they made vehicles cars it doesn't work
ñu defar avion soti wul
they made planes and it doesn't work
ñu def internet
they made the internet
te lu tax mu soti yalla rek xam
and nothing can bring you the wealth that you want Allah is the only one
so hagene ci bes bi ñu wax yomul la yan fo manu wala banun
if you reach the day that Allah said that nothing
will bring you the money ki lal nako tuti
Ibrahim rushed it when he was speaking
wadame ba nit ki dematul ba mu ngi teud
when you get to a point where you are laying down you can
yalla pare na mbiram
Allah has completely done with you.
Mun fa la sa balaqatul hulqum wa antum hina sintansurun wa nanu aqrabu ila minkum lakin la tubsirun. Suñ deme ba ruh ñew ba ci put mun man may ñew way du ngeen ma gis te ma leen ko gëna jëgé.
Allah when he said in suratul waqi'a when the ruh comes the soul comes into your to almost down to your throat coming out and you cannot do anything about it I will be the one that can do everything that.
Su ko defé lay yonent bi waxon ñew na nit bala mo faatu janok ajana wala mu janok safara.
Then we remember what the Prophet said before you die you will see heaven and hell
subbe soppeko ñu do communication bekk dañu yalla
when the face when the eyes change then the communication is cut between you
mom gis na fi mo dem du mëna wax lan la
he saw where he is going but he can't tell the people behind
su amé million ci armoram bi du ko japp
if he had $1 million in his coffers he can't
su do mom ñëwé taxaw sac bi fukki million nek ci du téré mu dem
if his son or his children any of his children
mo tax yowma bi nangul mu def li fakk la du al yowma bon tay la do waye yowmun pour bañ bis bi daf la bet do xam fa la yowmun yan fo mal wala banon doom ji taxaw du tere nga de ala jubere ji tere nga dem te fi nga dem gis nga ko te baxul te manut la wax ne da ba wagne ko
say when Allah said yawmun he said day that day is not the day their day but it's day that day when it comes it's not a known day because when it comes neither your children your wealth or anything in this world can stop you from it. It's not a known day it's a day that only he who knows
su ko defee nag ñu ngi ñaan yàlla balaa ñu àgg foofu ndax du munoon ñàkk foog ñu àgg fa yel na yéex lool yel na ñu fekk ci njub yel na ñu fekk ci ragal yàlla yel na ñu fekk ci sopp yonent bi yel na ñu tënkal suñ cër yi
protect our privates
akhlaq yi
and our minds
bañ baña def lu ko neexul
to avoid transgressing his boundaries
ndax kat ki nga gis mu jub du mom de
when you see somebody who's a straight person that's not
bu nit jubé yalla lay def
if you're straight is by the person
bu nit da ngay hit yalla lay def wala khalaqakum wama tahmalun ma len bind li ngay na def
if you think you do is by the mercy of Allah he created you and created everything that you do is on him
ñu ngi ñaan moom mi nga xam ne moom moom lépp.
We ask him to whom everything belongs.
Mu tànkatal ñu jamono.
That he tames this world for us.
Sidna Ali woy na àddina.
Sidna Ali Abi Talib said praise this dunya he wrote a poem about.
Tuddee ko Seynabu.
And he named it Zainab.
Waaye ci woy ya.
In that poem.
Nee na addaxru fihi taqayrun wa taqalub mu ne jamono. Day soppeeku day tourner.
He said in this dunya it changes and it turns.
Su tooné andula ak moom mu des mu bàyyi la fa.
If he turns and you don't turn with it, he'll leave you and continue.
Su soppee koo meloone moom mu bàyyi la fa.
If he changes and you don't change to fuck with it, and he'll leave you.
Moom lu mu ca tekkaale yu.
What the next thing he said.
Mu ne mu ngi wéy de xas àddina waaye na nga góorgóorlu ci àddina fii ngaa tabaxee àddina ba ngaa dem yoonam xëy am ëllëg.
Work hard enough that in this dunya that you will build your akhira before you go there.
Kon yéen yàlla jàpp nañu.
May Allah assist us.
Yéen yàlla jàpp nañu.
May Allah assist us.
Sëriñ bi yéen yàlla eggale ci maqaama yi bàyyi yam maam ya maam ya.
Sëriñ
ndaw yéen yàlla yokk leen yëkkati leen xaar leen sàmm leen.
Mbooloo
mi yàlla na yokku. Te lépp nekk yàlla kese. Di jaayu Moustapha Karim. Yéen yàlla nangul ñu.
Yéen
yàlla nangul ñu. Boole ñu ci jaam ñim gërëm. Tàggatal ñu jamono. Tàggatal ko suñ njoboot. li tax may ñaan tourné suñ njoboot yàlla bu leen jamono këf kii wax na ko léegi sangara ba muy wax sawut dégg maa nga laa maa nga xam li moo wax.
He said asking Allah to protect our children from alcohol. He said when Sheikh Ibrahim was talking about alcohol in Saudi Arabia. He knows what he meant. He doesn't speak English, but he knows what he's talking about.
Yàggoon na fa itam nag.
And this is not just new. This has been there.
Yàggoon na fa. Même Fatma fa nekkoon.
But during even the Fahad, the time of Fahad.
Waaw dafa mel ni naar ñoom man maay wax su ma meree ma ne. Su dul woon Kaaba gi alquran Makkay gën a nekk yëfër ñëpp.
If it was not the Kaaba and alquran Makka would be the worst place in the world.
Suñ ne Quraysh ñoo gën ci xeer ma ne tey xanaa.
If they say Quraysh are the best of the tribe. Tey maybe now.
Ñoom xam nañ ko.
Because of the prophet.
Démb Quraysh ñoo daan am doole dal ci sa ko rey la nangu sa alal ji. Su kooku màggee def ko su keneen màggee def ko loolu lañ fa nekkee woon booba.
Before the prophet they were the one who would get their strength.
Te Quraysh ñoo ko daan def.
And beat you up and take your wealth and move on. This was.
Dañ daan wax ne Banu Hashim a ci dàq xeex.
They used to call Banu Hashim the biggest wolf of the fighters.
Waa léegi bi yonent bi ñëwee judd ci seen biir.
When the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born in there.
Ci la leen kulóoraale.
Then he had changed them. He stayed
there. Li xaw yu foofu la.
And all of the blessings came.
Yonent bi nee na.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said.
Bu amee benn nit ku baax ci sa mbokk.
When you have one good person. In your family.
Yalla dana rust koku djegal temer yi worona dem safara.
Allah would bless 100 people in that family because of this good person.
Ñu ne ko fofu la hem mu ne dedet ak ñe dekk ak mom ci keur yi.
And even it will go past that to those who are neighbors.
Ñu ne fofu la hem mu ne dedet ak keur yi ko wër.
And those who even around those who are the neighbors of the.
Kon li yonent bi waxon ne julit mbiram dafa yeme bu ko bu ndaw jeme sax fek dafa am lu ko ci Yalla bu ko jox waye sonarul ko.
When Allah say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam. Ganaw yëngatu yëp lo yëngatu Yalla gërem.
Everything do you do Allah blesses it as
well. Dañ doon def benn conférence dama def conférence fële Route Island jeexal ñu ne beneen samedi waa Gambie dañ faa ma ne ah su ma ñëwee mu mel ni fonk ma leen. Ma dem ñu doon def conférence ba ci istighfar. Bañ demee bay jeexal nag am ku ne li borom risala wax tarkul asrar mu ne ba waxuñ nga ne taxfulah astaghfirullah tuubaa defaat waa ji ne boo defee juróom ñaar fukk boo tuuba yàlla du ko nangu ba ma paree ma ne ko góor nga baal maa ko. Yent yàlla Mouhamad nee na walaw alfu mara fi li yow mi. Soo tuubee yàlla baal la. Donte junne yoon nga def lu bon ci bés bi ñu ne ko lu tax mu ne comme yaa ngi yëg ne tabaraka wa taala mooy sa rom te nangu nga ko ci laa jaar yërëm la baal laa ko. Buñ de xatal yërmande yàlla nañ koy yaatal.
Waaw. He said when he finished his conference.
Wallaay.
He made a conference in Rhode Island and they told him that there was a conference in Gambia. He said if I go I demonstrate that I don't respect you. He had another conference that it was the theme of the conference was istighfar. One of the person was saying in the conference, if you make istighfar 70 times in a day, Allah would not forgive you. It's too much because you've done it so much. He said, ask the person and say, forgive me. But the Prophet ﷺ said, if you make a sin even 1,000 times in a day and Allah and ask Allah for forgiveness, He will forgive you because you know that you have a Lord that forgives sin and you turn back to Him asking for forgiveness.